Yeah, this hand's fine. It's not gonna be able to combo off through spot removal since the body snatcher's in our hand, but I think that's okay. Yeah, this hand's fine. We've got some cards to ca find other cards after he strips our hand here. Perfectly fine. If I was him, I would probably take the merchant scroll, depending on what his hand looked like. If he has like a hymn to Turok, I'd probably let me keep the merchant scroll and just take the ponder here. Give me less of a chance to find. Okay, he takes the hard combo piece. He drew another island. That's too many islands. I'm gonna draw the misdirection here and then the brainstorm later. And hopefully be able to merchant scroll away the Grave Titan. But if he does him me, I am going to misdirect it. So then I wouldn't have the merchant scroll anymore. Deathrite Shaman. That's scary. The way I think I beat Deathrite Shaman is I wait for him to activate it on my end of turn, just for something stupid like to exile something, and then I respond, flash, get the whole combo into play, and then on my turn I go infinite. Or I could draw the Miser Chain of Vapor that's in here somewhere. I think I fire off a brainstorm now. But I kind of want to have the red elemental blast up. So maybe that means I play the volcanic island and pass the turn. I don't hate that. Because I also don't want to brainstorm without being able to play a fetch land. So I'm just going volcanic pass turn. Okay. And he is going to go end of turn Deathrite. He might not even realize that that's leaving him vulnerable to the flash combo. If he has Jace here, I do not like casting it at all. Kind of needs to hold up a green source. I'm gonna fire off Brainstorm. That's just fine, apparently. This is not just fine though. Because I'm gonna have to redraw these cards. The Brainstorm's looking it. I kind of just want to flash in this Grave Titan, to be honest. And then cast Simian Spirit Guide. I might just do that. Feels kind of miserable. True Name Gnosis. Well, that plan would definitely make a couple 2/2 zombies look pretty bad. So I'm gonna try and counter this. Now, if I were to flash and he had spell pierce, that'd be pretty sad. So I think I'm gonna wait a turn, drop down to 14. I think that's fine. It's one less turn of tokens attacking him, but I think it's worth it to potentially play around a spell pierce. I guess I could cast the Simian Spirit Guide here, and then I still wouldn't be playing around Spell Pierce with the Flash, though. It's not like 2-2-2s is the biggest deal ever, though. I don't know. We know what we're drawing next turn, and we know it's very lackluster. I'm just gonna pass the turn. If he hymns us for some reason, we can hard cast Misdirection. Is one reason not to cast the Spirit Guide here. I don't think he's expecting this. It's brainstorming response. Okay, your brainstorm resolves. I was saying, might also not be worried because I had the Deathrite Shaman untapped. Just exile the Protean Hulk with its trigger on the stack. Oh, no, he's just gonna force the will that flash. Maybe I should have waited until I could have paid for Misdirection. We knew we had another dead draw coming up here, though. It's a little awkward. Our hand is the least exciting thing ever. Yeah, when I suggested Flash was fine, these were the hands I was thinking of. The ones that don't really do anything busted. The problem with the deck is there's no real big reason. There's no big incentive to unban it. Like, it's not like the deck is especially fun or good for the metagame. So, like, even if it's fine, it's like, why bother almost? I almost want a Merchant's Scroll for Brainstorm with this hand. I actually don't hate that. Our other option is to flash in Grave Titan and put in a couple 2-2s, which I also don't hate. I think I'm going to grab the Brainstorm, though. I'm just going to cast it now. Sweet. We can actually pay for Pact of Negation right now. Is pretty amazing. Yeah, he's still trying to race with the Deathrite Shaman. I think we're gonna win this game by doing some very fair things. Sword of Fire and Ice. So he's going to play that. He's going to equip it to his Deathrite Shaman. His Deathrite Shaman is going to be a 3-4. If I double block it with two Grave Titan tokens, I should be in pretty legit shape. He gets to kill one of them. I have 4 power versus his board. I think I can let this resolve. I'll have a Pact of Negation for his next creature, ideally. Jeez. Maybe I should have flashed in response to the sword. Because then I still could have packed the sword of fire and ice. The problem is then he wouldn't have attacked, and he would have had a 3-4 back on defense, whereas I really wanted him to attack. Okay. If I misdirection one of his fluster storms towards one of the copies, he doesn't have mana open to pay, and then I can pay with my last mana, so I should still be fine here. But it's going to take literal all of my cards. So let this go on the stack. He's going to choose targets. Yeah, this is actually, I know this is taking a little long, so this seems like it's taking a bit, but I assure you this is a sweet game. One of these other Flusterstorm copies. Oh my god, he says. So now it's going to be whether he draws another creature before we can beat him to death with our 2/2s. These games like this are why I really enjoy Magic the Gathering, where like, this is just clearly not what my deck is intended to do. But it might win here anyway. He's at 5. No! That's really bad for us. Let's see, so we need a Protean Hulk or a Chain of Vapor here. That's a Carrion Feeder. That's not useful. I think attacking him here is really bad. He gets to eat one and then untap and attack us and eat the other. Whereas if I just pass the turn, I at least get to chump once with a zombie. If I had black mana sources in the deck, I could just cast Carrion Feeder. Something that's really awkward is that there's no Carrion Feeder in the deck, so the deck can't really combo right now. But I think just Karmic Guiding back a Grave Titan would be fine. Definitely better to block than let him get the triggers, because he'll be eating a creature either way. Alright. He moves Sword over. If he moves Sword over, his other Deathrite Shaman's gonna die, but it prevents us from attacking. It's pretty break-even, I think. He chooses not to move. It's fine. Oh god, we are... In case you were wondering what drawing well looks like, it is not this. pretty sure it's correct for us to attack here. Doesn't really matter. Guy's gonna die anyway. We're gonna have one more turn to draw correctly. 5, 6, 7. And even then, we're gonna lose to a lot. Any piece of counter magic. Yeah, and he's leaving back Deathrite Shaman to prevent us from comboing. That's pretty smart. He gets to kill the Simian Spirit Guide. This was a very close game. But he had a lot of live draws, and he hit a few turns. True name. So good. That's a summoner's pact. The problem is we can't pay for summoner's pact, so we kinda have to win with it. But I think we boarded out a carrion feeder in order to get in. So the summoner's pact gets Protean Hulk. We flash in Protean Hulk. We fetch. I don't even know. Nothing, because nothing wins in this board state. Should let you look at your sideboard. I'll just, I mean. So we fetch Protean Hulk. Play it. Go get Body Snatcher, Benevolent Bodyguard. Body Snatcher enters play. Discard it to, or discard the carrion feeder to it. But then we have no way for the Body Snatcher to die. The problem is if we had tried to combo off during his attack step so that the Body Snatcher could block Deathrite Shaman, so that we can't actually win the game until our turn because of how the combo interacts. It needs an attack step, and we would die to the Summoner's Pact on our upkeep. So we're just dead here. Concede. And it was all because we boarded in that stupid Grave Titan instead of Carrion Feeder. Although, if we hadn't had the Grave Titan this game, if that had been the redundant Carrion Feeder, we would have drawn both redundant Carrion Feeders anyway and lost because of that for one, and then for two we would have lost a Sword of Fire and Ice a bit earlier than we actually did. So kind of an interesting game. Okay, what did that game teach us? The game taught me not much of anything. It taught me I kind of want another carrion feeder in here. I think he boarded out all of his removal. I don't actually think we need the Benevolent Bodyguard shenanigans. Like, just go full combo you and bring in some Clasms. I don't hate that. Kind of want another Rev then. Yeah, I'm like, cut a probe, or a chain of vapor. I'm gonna do this. Yep. No. yeah, I'm gonna do this.